Hey, happy Wednesday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Got a huge update on what is coming after we deal with Rafael and what is potentially happening with Rafael. So you can see it has strengthened back up to where it's still going to get that Cat 2 status. When it gets to this portion over here in the Gulf of Mexico, it's going to go north or south. So what it does is it has a high pressure over here that is combating, trying to bring this to the north. We have a trough that's going to try and pull it to the north. And we got a high pressure over here that's trying to pull it down to the south. Now, as you can see, the latest track has trended further to the west, just like the Euro was showing, but then trying to bend northward like the GFS is showing. Remember, the trend a long time ago was always a figure S. Now, you can see for Rafael, as it goes towards Cuba, it is bringing some strong winds, bringing sustained winds of 109 miles per hour as it comes right across a little west of Havana as it's leaving the Cayman Islands. And you can also see with a little bit of the unknown, the uncertainty cone. That's why you see this big circle. It's either going to curve and weaken from a Cat 1 hurricane to still a tropical storm, or it's going to go further towards the south. I'm still showing there will be no serious impacts on the northern Gulf of Mexico. Still maybe a little bit of some 30 miles per hour wind gusts may come across, and maybe a chance for a tornado, but all that is actually starting to dwindle down. But things could change pretty quickly, because after all this gets shoved down towards the southern Gulf of Mexico, I'm showing on the latest run with the Euro that it could strengthen back up and try and do another little wobble, because that trough could pull it up while it gets together with this piece of wave that's getting all bottled up towards the Yucatan. Something could come out of this later. Latest update shows that disturbance is at 20% chance of formation just to a tropical depression in the next 48 hours, 30% in the next 7 days. More likely we'll run out of time, but when all this starts bottling up over here between multiple waves and what's left of Rafael, it could hang around and come back later. Now, you can see the latest information on global tropics after we deal with this from the 13th all the way through the 19th. Remember, I'm still showing that we got chances all the way into December, but you see chances for formation as going all the way from the eastern Pacific, southern Gulf of Mexico, western Caribbean, all the way towards the greater Antilles and the lesser Antilles. A big area. Then, once we go past that, from the 20th through the 26th of November, still showing that, but it's going a little further towards the north on the chance for tropical development. And like I said, I'm still showing chances all the way into December. But you can also see that over here for the eastern side of the lower 48, that you're going to go into this pattern still where you're going to have above average temperatures. And you can see the update on the Arctic Oscillation that the GFS has come back from yesterday, trending with the Korean model, trending with the Euro, that we're still going to get a couple of cold fronts. The cold air is still coming in gradually, but it's still way far northern than that southern dip that we saw with GFS. So maybe a quick dip come in a couple of times. You can see the two little troughs of cold air to come in, but it's not going to stay long. It's going to warm up every single day when it does come through. You can see the latest with your MJ, or your lift in the atmosphere, that we still have favorable environment, rise in motion moving through our area all the way through the 11th of November, showing the latest information on our potential velocity anomaly. We still have all this favorable environment all the way to the 11th. That's right into our region. After that, everything is kind of on a eastern push rather than this Gulf of Mexico that push that you see here. So everything will be a little more to the east as it forms up. Also showing it's going to be there all the way into the 20s of November as well, coming right back into our region potentially. Now you can see the same update with the Euro dealing with this intensity pushing further to the west. But afterwards, as we go into the 20th and before that, you can see a little bit of that eastern push on those other waves. Now, what comes in the 20th could be in the same scenario in the Western Caribbean we need to watch out for. But still showing as we go in late November into December, we still have storms and potential lift coming in our area. So we still can have our hurricane season well into December. And you can see with the ocean forecast system, we still have very warm waters in the Gulf of Mexico. And as it goes further towards that westward push, it has more intensity, more strength, more warm waters for this to grow a little bit. And if it don't get shoved into the eastern Pacific, it could bottle up a little bit right here, like Milton did, I'm afraid. And when we get that trough coming out of that storm, pulling this system from the Caribbean to that north, potentially still something very weak. It could get together with this down here, and we could have an issue later. But you also can see as you go forward with the forecast system, as you go all the way to the 12th, we still have very warm waters in the Caribbean and in the Gulf of Mexico. And you can see the latest from National Hurricane Center showing it will go into the center of the Gulf of Mexico, but still is going to weaken down. And you can see this on the latest intensity that after it becomes that tropical storm, that it will go down to 60 miles per hour, then 40 miles per hour, and just really go away. So here's the latest tropical cyclone forecast for the path. And you see how it shows it could do some early turns. Majority shows that it will be further towards the west as you go 48 hours. And showing as it goes towards 3 to 4 days, it's really going to slow down as it tries to go north a little bit. Majority of them shows it will get pulled back down towards the south. And showing it'd be over here in 3 to 5 days. Showing it'd be in the southern Gulf or going into Mexico. Potentially still a hurricane. And you can see this on the latest guidance of intensity, showing it more likely will stay at least a Cat 1 hurricane all the way till Saturday and Sunday. It could go down towards a tropical storm. See how some of these show it does strengthen back up right there as well. And you got this group shows it could stay a Cat 1, even get really intense and go back towards a major hurricane or even a Cat 4. But you can see in 72 hours that it will do that curve and try and do that quick wobble, more likely will not make that wobble. And within 4 to 5 days, go further towards the south, then eventually heads to the south. While we get our next wave coming through and all that could merge together, but then maybe get stopped by this big high pressure and block it all and suppress it all down. But you can see this with the hurricane analysis system. After it goes through the Gulf, the shear really hits on it as it tries to do that northern wobble, that southern wobble, just wobbles around and then just weakens it down greatly right there. Now, this is still bringing chances for tropical storm force winds over towards the Florida Keys and still bring this banding right across as you go by this afternoon into tonight, bringing you chances for tornadoes for southern Florida. So for today, you do have chances for tornadoes. You got the 2%. You also got the 5% for the Florida Keys and Naples, Key Largo, and Marathon. Now, this is also when we're starting to get that trough of that system coming in. And for Texas, you have chances for hail, chances for wind for tomorrow. But you also have a little bit of a tornado threat that could grow some more. So far, they have San Angelo. So you can see that you start getting these storms for today as you go through the evening for Georgia, for South Carolina, a little bit of the western Florida coast. Then it builds up as you go through tonight and overnight, also through the Florida Keys. Then you get some more going through Kentucky as well, and it goes along the coast of Georgia and South Carolina. While you still get that big pattern of very cold air, bringing a lot of snowfall, anywhere from 1 to 2 feet plus. Then as you go through for tomorrow, then you start getting those storms building up for Texas, bringing you chances for the damaging winds, the hail, and the chances for tornadoes. Showing so far on the snowfall, anywhere from 1 to 2+ feet, almost getting chances for 3 feet for eastern Colorado and northeastern New Mexico. Then we're going to be in a transition where this starts going towards the western Gulf of Mexico. And you can see with the Euro that as it gets stopped right there, that it actually gets favored by the high pressure over here, right over Texas and Mexico. This is what's going to help bring this system further towards the south, while this all carries to the western Caribbean and brings that into the Gulf as well. We see how everything just kind of swishes around as we go through that next phase. So we definitely need to watch this. As you can see, the latest with the Euro brings it all to the west. It gets sheared. It stays a little further towards the south, weakens down, and goes that way towards Mexico. But you can see if you just look at the latest 90 hours, when you look at the intensity, look at this 6Z, the latest update, it shows it a stronger system. So we need to watch what's going on with this as it goes towards the southern side of the Gulf of Mexico. It could get suppressed down kind of like Milton and maybe come back. Showing for the next 6 days, it is going to bring heavy precipitation across Georgia and South Carolina, anywhere from 2 to 4 inches of rainfall. Also across the South Tennessee, Kentucky Valley, and the South Central from what's going on with all this rainfall. Then we got that trough coming in, why you could get some precipitation also off Rafael. And that starts adding up why you get one wave and another wave coming in. Now for today, you do have your chance for flash flooding. You have the marginal, you got the slight risk going all the way from southern Alabama all the way towards Columbia, South Carolina, but you also got the moderate level risk going from Georgia all the way in towards Augusta and western South Carolina. So just be aware this is going to bring some pounding on the streets, even some localized flooding. Now for tomorrow, this is going to change. You have your slight risk, you have your marginal, but we also have this storm system that's growing over here further south. So you have your marginal and your slight risk for flash flooding as well. And as you go through Friday, this is going to grow some. It's going to grow into Kansas and a little bit of southern Nebraska with your flash flooding. Once you go to Saturday, it's going to move around and Sunday. But you can see the pivotal point right here with GFS, literally right before 72 hours. Here's your high pressure steering this also, and here's your upper level high steering this also. So they're kind of combating each other. That's why it's moving very slowly. Now we look at the latest run, you can see it's a little bit further towards the south, and it really dissipates really quickly. Still could bring you that small tornado threat, not showing it as severe as yesterday, while we get that next system bundling around in the Caribbean, showing a lot of weakness on all of these for today. So when you look at the latest trends, you can see the GFS showing it weakening down, going right towards Louisiana, then getting pushed back a little bit, not doing anything. The 6Z shows a little more of the same thing, a little more to the west, but as it weakens down, then it gets pulled back towards what the Euro is seeing and just dissipates and goes away. Showing either one you go on, maybe 30 miles per hour wind gusts coming with that. You can see with the latest update, the 6Z is even further away from landfall, not showing serious impacts still for the northern Gulf of Mexico. And you can see the latest National Hurricane Center. It's still too soon to determine what, if any, impacts from Rafael could bring to portions of the northern Gulf Coast. And looking at the trends, the spire, the one that goes by the satellites, look at this. This one shows the same thing as the GFS. It could weaken down, go right to the north, no threat to anyone. The Euro AI, artificial intelligence, showing the same thing, weaken down and try and go to the north. Still no threat. So the latest ensembles, you can see right here with the Euro, showing if it goes north, it will be something very weak, nothing to worry about. But this could go over in the southern Gulf and strengthen, actually sit there. And when we get that trough of that storm system come in, while this is trying to come in and form in the Caribbean, as we go past the 10th, it could come back like Milton did. Now, we're not seeing this in any of the models, but still, you can see this one over here going to the west as well. So I think the second one has a good chance to get suppressed down. We're supposed to be getting a high pressure that's going to either bring everything down or bring everything out through the east. We need to watch out what's happening with Rafael. A lot of them show it weaken down and go away, but we do have an ensemble that says it could be an issue later on. The Canadian sees this weakening down also, going north and just dissipating. Also, that next wave coming by the Bahamas shows you could get that tropical depression, but it would be short-lived. And then we get that next system coming in the Caribbean past the 10th. And that's the one that could be an issue, but showing it probably will get suppressed down by a high pressure. This is the one that could go into the eastern Pacific. The one before this, the one we need to watch, is going to be next. But you can see with the winds from that, still not showing any impacts for y'all on the North Gulf Coast. That next wave might bring 50 miles per hour wind gusts towards the Bahamas, the Greater Antilles, then that third wave coming through. So we do need to watch this transition. It could be tricky. Now, before I go, 1 Timothy 4:1-5. Now, the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the later times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats, which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. For every creature of God is good, and nothing to be refused, if it be received with thanksgiving. For it is sanctified by the word of God and prayer. Amen. Have a great evening, everybody. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Thank you for helping spread the word, keeping safety within the community. That's the best thing we could practice, is safety with everyone, especially in these times. Remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody.